The following program comes to you in color from Hollywood. The heart of the entertainment world. The Hollywood Palace. Schreiber, Lana, Cantrell, Damorra, Jackie, Leonard, Mort Sahl, Mitchellers of the Hollywood Palace Orchestra. This portion brought to you by
Pepto-Bismol, the stomach medication with potability that spreads like a creamy blanket of relief over your upset stomach, and by Bayer Aspirin. Bayer is pure aspirin, not just part aspirin. Bayer aspirin. Bayer works wonders.
We'll return to the Hollywood Palace after a word from one of our sponsors.
Has anyone ever improved on Bayer aspirin, made a faster aspirin, a more effective aspirin? Lots of people have tried. They took plain aspirin, made it bigger, smaller. They buffered it. They added extra ingredients. They squeezed it, squared it, flavored it, gummed it, capsuled it, fizzed it, even tried spraying it. They did everything but improve it. Today, there's still nothing faster, nothing more effective than good old genuine Bayer aspirin. It's pure aspirin, not part aspirin. It works wonders for headache, muscle pain, aches, and fever of a cold, for just about anything that hurts. Nothing bigger, smaller, in any size, in any shape, none of them is faster or more effective than Bayer aspirin. Even we can't improve it, though we keep trying. Bayer works wonders.
And now, from the Hollywood Palace, here is your host, one of Hollywood's outstanding actors and entertainers, Gene Barry!
Poets have extolled the golden days of old, when a home was not a pad, and a cat was not a lad, and abroad was a trip across the sea. Was that period sublime, the grand and graceful time, when people lived a life so charmingly? Why, I loved their attitude and pose, especially the fashions and the clothes. Shoes were spattered, heads were hatted, every swain wore a cane on his arm. Activated and created charm. Ties were ascot and every lascar overawed when he jawed her a smile. Single-breasted, double-vested style. The style would beguile, the girl would react to the swain with the cane and the charm. Then after a while, just because of his smile, the swain had the cane and the girl on his arm. They went parading, promenading, looking proud as the crowd craned their necks. As they passed him, how they gassed him. Sex. Of course, that was in our grandfather's time, my friends, when life was a lot easier and more elegant. Today, you look at the young people, things are a lot different. She won't by heels. He wears high heels. People gawk when they walk arm in arm. Messy madam, front Charles Adams. Charm, her hair's faded. His is braided. Disarray lacquer sprayed it from tile. Fingers scratching, could be catching. Style, why the style is so vile with a hair everywhere that you'd swear that her hair is a mop. And did you perchance take a glance at their pants? Their pants are so tight that the skin is on top. Why, he looks Spanish and she looks mannish. Which is which? It's a switch that's complex. She'll wear earrings, he wears earrings. Sex, why she looks so virile. And he looks like zero. Oh, heaven, strange, but everything mundane. Style, 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 style and
thank you very much. It's so very nice to be with you again in the Hollywood Palace, and it's especially nice to be back home again. You know, in the past year, I've been to Africa, where I made a picture called Maroc 7, which will be released soon. Uh-huh. And I've been playing in nightclubs in Australia, Japan, and England. I've been doing a lot of traveling and racing for planes. I'm packing and practically never in Los Angeles. Whoops, I'm beginning to sound like Mayor Yawdy. Well, we have a great show for you tonight. Lots of singing and dancing, and it's loaded with laughs.
I think so, too. I'll tell you right now.
Thank you, Paul. It's good to see you. I want to tell you right now, it's really nice being on this very wonderful show with you, because you're really a nice fella.
Yeah.
I think so. This is going to be very interesting. Hello, hello, baby.
I was afraid of that, Jack. You know, can't you just come in gentlemanly and say, hi, Gene?
What, are you some kind of help nut or something? You know, I'm only kidding. I always liked you. I always liked the... Don't touch me. I'm a star. I told you. After all, man, after all, I have known you a long time. I even liked you when you went in the name of William S. Hart many years ago.
Jack, you know, I'm a little disappointed.
I think you should be. I've heard your work.
No, I wanted to give you a big introduction. After all, I'm responsible. I didn't want to say this, but I'm responsible for you being on the show tonight.
Oh, you must be kidding. I've been a big star all over the whole world. I didn't have to go to Australia. I work in America, you know.
No, Jack, I mean it, really. You know, they were talking about who we would have on the show, and they named every comedian they could think of.
I think so.
And after they got through naming all the comedians, I remember...
You what?
I recommended you.
I wonder how you'd look with a microphone sticking out of your head. Yeah, that's pretty hilarious. I tell you, for a guy with a Rolls Royce and has got no show, you certainly have a lot of confidence. Very nice, but don't touch me. I told you 1,000 times. And don't put your hands on your hips. There's been talk around the union. I'll tell you. Don't touch me. I'm a star, man. Hey, don't be nervous. Now smile. Don't fold your arms. They'll bury you around here, pal.
You mentioned my Rolls Royce.
I mentioned Rolls Royce. Where is that rented job you got?
Well, it happens to be right out there in the parking lot.
I wasn't too sure because I touched it on the automobile club. Take the Mustang pledge.
What'd you say?
The Mustang pledge. Oh. M-U-S-T-A-N-G. There's an army. Hello, officer.
Now, Jack, now wait a minute.
Please.
You know that I'm the host of the show, and I've got to introduce the first act.
Oh, I suppose one of those elephants again, huh?
We're starting off with a very big attraction, yes.
One of those elephants again.
But you're very close, as a matter of fact. Yeah? Ladies and gentlemen, Jack Leonard.
Wonderful fair of that, Jack. That fella's really a nice guy. I want to wish you continued success on whatever you try next year. Really a nice guy, and I think he's got a great future. I've been in this particular line of business. Come here, folks. I want to tell you something. Maybe you want me to have the stuff typewritten, you go home and study it for 3 days. I'm very happy to be back here again in this very wonderful show, the Hollywood Palace, because I just came in from New York, You know, New York City, there's a shopping center about 2,000 miles from here. Oh, shut up, you old bag, and I want to see you. Now, the first fellow I said hello to yesterday was my very good friend, the former producer of this show, Mr. Nick Vanoff, a very well-fettled fellow. I shook Mr. Vanoff's hand. I now have athlete's foot. I want to be a big hit tonight because my niece is out there. She's attending school at UCLA, and she's majoring in Spanish because she wants to live in New York. I tell you, by matter of fact, we got so many Puerto Ricans in my neighbor, New York, even a synagogue is called Temple Emmanuel. You know, I'm working live, you know. Well, we're going to do a very wonderful song for a picture I just completed called Somewhere in This Wide, Wide World There's a Wide, Wide Girl for Me. And also did some recordings with on the Condemned label with a very wonderful orchestra, which shall be nameless, Mitchell Ayers and his nameless orchestra. And there's a very wonderful song called Ever Since You Lost Your False Teeth, I Can See the Shadow of Your Smile. And on the flip side of that is a very beautiful song called There's a Bluebird on My Shoulder, and it's getting pretty messy up here. And that's why I say, my friends, remember the words of the great painter Van Gogh, who once said, huh? Further, like a nice welcome for my accomplice, ladies and gentlemen, the illegitimate son of Mr. Moto. You want to buy an American transistor? Be nice tomorrow. Let's go out and take some pictures of the military installation. He likes me because he thinks I'm a Jewish Buddha. He keeps sprinkling rice around my feet all day long, but I'll be darned if I let him burn incense in my navel. That's why I say, my friends, remember the words of Senator Dirksen, who once said, oh, oh, oh. I'm a little song right now, pal, but don't get overconfident because that's how you blew the war. Come on, keep pumping till the monkey comes back.
Your company picks up your contract. Ladies and gentlemen, the original Captain Trap and Sound of Music
and the infamous submarine commander in The Russians Are Coming, The Russians Are Coming. Always a marvelous troubadour, Theodore Bikel.
Поговори же ты со мной, подруга семиструнная, вся душа полна тобою, а ночь такая лунная. Давай раз, еще раз, еще много, еще много раз, раз, еще раз, еще много, много. Ах, тебя я узнаю, Мор твой временной, и мелодию твою в частом переборе. Раз, да еще раз, да еще много раз, эх, раз, да еще раз, да еще много, много раз, эх, раз, да еще раз, да еще много, много раз, эх, раз, да еще раз, да еще много, много раз. У меня жена была,
я помню, дорогой,
она мне изменила, изменила только раз. А потом решила, раз, еще раз, еще много, много раз, 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 раз, еще раз, много, много раз, раз, еще раз.
Well, as you may have gathered, this was a Russian song, a genuine Russian song called Two Guitars. Usually it's played on one guitar, but tonight, thanks to my friend Alex Hasilev, we played it on two guitars. Now, you may ask, where does he learn? Where does one learn these songs? Not in Moscow. One learns them in Paris and in New York. There's a place there, used to be, called the Kretchma. And I used to go there and spend money I didn't have on champagne I didn't want and hate myself. And out of this hatred came a song.
When you hear Russian songs, do you suffer? Does your heart start to pound in your chest? If you do, then come down to the Kretchma. It costs plenty, but it's from the best. And there is singing, and there is dancing, and the Russian vodka is all right. Come to the Kretchma, that's where you catch ma. Drinking vodka every night, I in the corner is standing a Koza. You can see him from way down the block. And inside the candles are gleaming. But except for the candles, it's dark. There is singing and there is dancing, and the Russian vodka is all right. Come to the Kretchma, that's where you catch ma. Drinking vodka every night. In the middle
Natasha. All the men are beginning to pant. When she's dancing, her shoulders, they vibrate. And when she's singing, you see that she can't. And there is singing, and there is dancing, and the Russian baritones are right. Come to the Kretchma, that's where you get Kretchma, making whoopee every night.
Here's a pleasant surprise for people with indigestion or heartburn. New Pepto-Bismol tablets. They work two ways. One, they neutralize excess stomach acid for fast relief. Two, their coating action protects your stomach lining against excess acid for prolonged soothing relief. Get both, acid neutralizer and stomach coating action. Carry good-tasting, chewable pink Pepto-Bismol tablets.
Think. 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 Think of all the things in your home that can burn you.
Ouch.
That's why it's good to keep a reliable friend on hand. Unguentine. Unguentine has, well, it has a long name and does a fast job. Cools burning pain. You unburn with unguentine for fast temporary relief. Do you have unguentine in your home?
Ouch.
After all, you never know when you might need it.
Now, wait a minute.
I need $5 for a haircut.
Now, wait a minute. What's going on down there?
Trying to get $5.
Young man, I heard you ask that party for $5. You know, there'll be no panhandling in the Hollywood Palace.
Well, I've got him. I've got him.
Where are you going?
Well, I've got to meet my partner.
Oh, your partner. You're Avery Schreiber of that fabulous comedy team of Burns and Schreiber. And there's his partner, Jack Burns, doing the sketch, The Panhandler.
Could you give a quarter to a starving man?
Hey, it's me.
Oh, hi, Harvey. How are you?
What are you doing running around with your head down on the ground asking for money?
Well, I can't look at anybody in the eye and say I'm starving, really.
Listen, if you want to be a panhandler, Malcolm, you've got to make eye contact. You know what I mean?
Eye contact.
Huh?
Yeah. Eye contact.
Yeah. This is merchandising. This is the most important thing, selling yourself if you're going to be a successful panhandler.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, sure. Look, I got a few minutes. I'll teach you what I know about the art of panhandling.
You promise me that?
Yes, I will.
It's an art.
Oh, it is. It's
not
art.
A technique.
It's an art.
It's an art.
It's an art.
So, very good.
All right, now, I have about 5 minutes. I have to get down to Republican headquarters and panhandle there, so I'll teach you what I can.
Are they good for money, then?
Are you kidding? They'd much rather give it to you directly than support a welfare state. Sure.
Yeah, you think good.
All right, all right. Now, look, there are many approaches you can use. You can use the direct approach, the veteran's approach, or the handicapped approach, you see? These are all approaches, ploys, designed to gain sympathy for you.
It's a way to bilk them out of their money.
I'd rather say ploy, if you don't mind, all right? We got a great corner to work here. We have a bank over there, and we have the bus stop here. We get them coming and going, all right?
Right.
All right, now I'll show you what I mean by I'll use the veteran's approach.
Okay.
All right, now stand back unobtrusively, I'll use the veteran's approach, all right? Excuse me, sir. Could you spare $500 for a veteran, 1st Marine Division, 5th Marines, Korea, 1950-51? Thank you very much.
What'd you get?
A discharge button. Did you try?
Yeah, I wasn't the veteran.
Well, why? What do I...
Excuse me, sir, but I was a Hessian mercenary.
What is that? Who's going to give money to a Hessian mercenary?
I don't know. He looked like he was with the CIA.
Look, let's set up a hypothetical situation here.
Hypothetical?
Yeah, a real one. Now, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll come out of the bank. I'm going to pretend that I'm a bank employee heading home after a hard day's work. You understand?
Yeah.
You've got 5 seconds to get the money from me. I'll come by. I'm heading home.
You go home 3 times a day.
All right. Now, when I come out of the bank, remember, you got to psych me out. I may have a lot
psych
of...
Psych you out.
Yeah, I have a lot of problems. I've had a very hard day. May have been going home to an unhappy marriage. You don't know. You got 5 seconds to get the money, all right?
5 seconds.
I'll come out of the bank. All right.
Okay.
Be sure and put all the money away in there. Don't leave it lying around like you did last week. That's sloppy. Oh, that was a hard day. That was one of the hardest days I had. A very hard day. Well, home.
Excuse me, it looked like it was a hard day.
Get away from me. What are you, some kind of bearded nut? You nut, you nut, you weird nut, you hairy nut. I hate nuts. Get out of here.
What was that?
What happened?
You called me a nut.
I didn't. He did. Now, why did he do that?
Well, wait till he comes back. I'll punch him in the mouth. I'm not a nut.
No, that was a transference of aggression. Maybe he was a nut. I told you he had a psycho.
You're darn right he was a nut. The guy comes out of there like a steamroller. How do you handle a guy like that?
It's no problem.
Okay, I'll be the same guy. I'm coming out of the bank. It's a hard day. You got 5 seconds to psych me out. All right, put that money away. Oh, boy, that was a hard day. Boy, that's about the hardest day I've ever had. That was even harder than Tuesday. And Tuesday was such a hard day, it reminded me the day before Thanksgiving. Everybody came in with checks, and nobody had identification. I had nickels, dimes, quarters. That reminded me about the day we had the anniversary. It was a party all night long. I couldn't stand it. I had a headache. It was the worst day possible, and nobody had identification.
Will you come on?
Oh, home again, home again, home again.
Pardon me.
I'm a nut!
You weren't the nut. He was the nut.
No, I over-identified.
All right, look. I'll tell you what. We'll try one more approach here, Milt. We'll try the handicapped approach, all right?
Handicapped?
Yeah, you pretend you're deaf and dumb. You're halfway there. All right. I'll tell you. You make gestures to indicate you can't talk and you can't hear, all right? You make those gestures to gain sympathy for you. Is that clear? You understand what I'm saying now? Is that clear to you now? Not now. All right, come out of the bank. Now, I'm going to come out of the bank. You got 5 seconds to get the money. 5 seconds. Get it, all right? I'm not going to be the same guy I was before. I'm a different guy. I'm a different guy. Not the same guy.
Well, I recognize you.
Yep, I'm going to be a different guy. Don't you understand? I'm going to assume a characterization.
You're going to make off like somebody else.
Get the money. I'm not fooling around with you anymore. Boy, I'm tired of fooling around with you. All right. All right. I'm tired. All right. Now. I'm going to come out of the bank. All right.
Okay.
Get the money.
Now try this new way to accent your figure. Cross your heart, see? You're suddenly shapelier. Well, that's what this new Playtex Fashion Magic cotton bra does. It crosses your heart with stretch to lift and separate. You're suddenly shapelier. This cross your heart shaping is only on Playtex regular Fashion Magic bras and new longline styles. Cross your heart. You'll be shapelier, honestly. And here's news about girdles.
Most women wish a girdle made them firm and flatter here. A new firm and flatter Playtex Lycra girdle firms and flatters as no other girdle can. The exclusive V construction exercises two firming, flattering forces. These elastic V bands lift your tummy in. These elastic bands keep your waistline thin. You're firmer, you're flatter in the new Playtex girdle made with Lycra. Firm and flatter.
Lana Cantrell, the new singing sensation from Australia, was described by Time magazine recently as a slangy, swinging blonde with a communicable crush on life. We're happy to present her here tonight, Miss Lana Cantrell.
Isn't it a lovely day to be caught in the rain? You were going on your way, now you've got to remain. Just as you were going, leaving me all at sea. The clouds broke, they broke, and oh, what a break for me. I can't see the sun up high, though we're caught in the storm. I can see where you and I could be cozy and warm. Let the rain tip-to-patter, well, it really doesn't matter if the skies are gray. As long as I can be with you, it's a lovely day. Isn't it a lovely day to be caught in the rain? You were going on your way, now you've got happiness survives. And I'll remember as the years go by, till the day I die, that we were lovers. And I'll remember as the years go by, till the day I die, that we were lovers. You.
Lots more show on tonight's Hollywood Palace, including Mort Sahl and the unusual novelty turn from Czechoslovakia, Damorra and her doves. It's a real heavyweight second half. Oh, I hope Jackie Leonard doesn't think I'm introducing him again. We'll be right back.
The 7-minute cigarette. It makes the good taste last longer because it is longer. The longest length you can get in a filter cigarette. It's Pall Mall Gold 100s with 7 minutes of good, mild taste. The 7-minute cigarette. Pall Mall Gold 100s. Mild taste in a longer length.
And now here's a real ladybird from Czechoslovakia, Damorra and her doves.
Amelia, Fiddler on the Roof. If I were a wealthy man, what is a rich man? A man with all the material things? No, not really. He's a man who nurtures his child from the cradle to that blessed moment when he's standing with her under the canopy on her wedding day. Is this the little girl I carried? Is this the little boy at play? I don't remember growing older. When did they? When did she get to be a beauty? When did he grow to be so tall? Wasn't it yesterday when they were small? Sunrise, sunset, swiftly flow the years. One season following another, laden with happiness and tears. Now is the little boy a bridegroom? Now is the little girl a bride? Under the canopy I see them, side by side. Place the gold ring upon a finger, share the sweet wine and break the glass. Soon the full circle will have come to pass. Sunrise, sunset, swiftly fly the years. One season following another,
What's the matter?
Oh, I still have that same silly headache.
Did you take aspirin?
I did, but I've still got it.
I'll take some more.
I'm not supposed to. Not for another couple of hours.
You never know how annoying a headache's going to be. So the minute your head starts hurting, take Bufferin. With Bufferin, you've got more going for you against pain. Compared to simple aspirin tablets, Bufferin delivers nearly twice as much of this pure pain reliever when you need it most. Take Bufferin. It's faster, more effective than simple aspirin tablets. With Bufferin, you've got more going for you against pain.
If I use new band spray deodorant, will they talk to me at the women's club tonight?
If you don't use it, they may talk about you. Change to BAN, the spray that won't wear off as the day wears on. New BAN spray.
Try it!
It's now my pleasure to introduce one of America's cleverest and most perceptive humorists, Mort Sahl.
What's that blackboard for?
Gene, I thought we'd have a little illustrated discussion about politics tonight.
Well, what do I know about politics? I'm an actor.
You don't know it, but that statement just won you the nomination as the next governor of California.
Okay.
Now, as you all know, politics is supposed to be divided up into two groups, the left and the right. I'm going to show you how to use a chart tonight based on psychometrics, semantics, and calculus so that you'll be able to classify anybody in the world politically. Now, I did all the math, so I'll show you how this works. You ain't play this game with your date on the way out of the theater. we like to bring people together. Now, the chart goes like this. It has two categories. Up here, we have the left wing. You can shudder if you'd like. The left wing is made up of the Communist Party, which has a membership, I'm sorry to say, of 4,000, 3,000 of whom are FBI agents. Over here, we have the right wing, which is made up of various people, John Birch Society, capitalism, fascism, and finally, greed, if we can work it out. That's over here. Now, the question is, where is everybody? Because that's certainly not any of us. Most people are in the... they're in the middle because you lose your job if you stay here, and you have to go to too many meetings if you belong to this. So most people are here. And most people are in the middle. They're middle-of-the-road people. In Europe, they're called social democrats in German elections. So we'll call them social democrats. And now, in these groups, there are also people who are left of others and right of others. So we'll fractionate this, if we may, here. And we got a lot of chalk, a lot of interest. Not much time, but that's all right. Here's the left wing, middle of the road of the left wing, and the right wing of the left wing. Got that? All right. Over here, we have the left wing social democrats, middle of the road, and the right wing of the social democrats. And of course, over here, we have the right wing of the right wing, middle of the road, and the left wing, oddly enough, of the right wing. Now, this may confuse you. Most people, of course, are here. They got out of college, and they got worried. So they get married, and they move into the valley, and they gain weight, and hair falls out and everything. And they have minority group members where they're maids, and they talk to them while they're sweeping because they're guilty. They watch David Susskind, and if you argue with them about politics, they say, well, even the New York Times feels this way. And they have a Mustang, think it's a sports car. They're all in here, right? That's it. So those are those people. Now I'll show you how these people break down. Now take an issue like the Vietnamese conflict, and I'll show you how it works. Starting on the left here. The left-wing position is the Americans must get out. I don't care about any unilateral. They must get out. That's that position. That would be here. Middle-of-the-road communist position is they don't have to get out, but they should stop bombing the North. That's their position. The right-wing, left-wing position is they should stop bombing and they should start getting out, and we should open up the area to trade because their money's as good as anyone else's. This position is, I don't like them either, but, I mean, my goodness, you know. This position is, we got so many men in Vietnam, what if the communists just strike somewhere else? I mean, I hope McNamara knows what he's doing, that's all. Now, the right-wing social democrats, which is where most everybody in America is, say, the war is a dirty job, but someone's got to do it. That's their right. Now, when you move into the right wing here, the left wing of the right wing says the war is a dirty job, and fortunately, we got to do it. It's a little different, that little jump here. Middle of the road here of the right wing says, why don't we escalate? Bombing the North, let's bomb Peking. And this group, of course, says, let's bomb them on Sunday. So in other words, what we have here is Ho Chi Minh is a left-wing left-winger. Fidel Castro, middle of the road of the left wing. Sister works at CIA. Loses points as a left-winger. Kosygin in Russia is a right-wing left-winger. Left-wing social democrats, we don't have any. Middle-of-the-road social democrats would be Wayne Morse, Martin Luther King. Most Negro leaders are middle-of-the-road social democrats till they get their rights, then they become right-wing social democrats. Almost everybody is a right-wing social democrat. That would be Eisenhower, Romney, Rockefeller, Javits, Kuchel, former Governor Brown, and Frank Sinatra, Kim Novak, Jack Jones, goes on now, Huntley and Brinkley, they're here, Peter Jennings. left wing of the right wing, Arthur Goldberg would be here, and he would be there. Middle of the road of the right wing would be the president, Humphrey, and Nixon. They all have the same position on the war. And Marshall Key and some other people are here. Now, Humphrey is an interesting case because Humphrey has five positions. He's in the middle of the road of the right about the war, but the president doesn't know it. The president took Humphrey because he thinks Humphrey is a right-wing social democrat. Mrs. Humphrey thinks that Humphrey's a left-wing social democrat. Robert Humphrey, his son, thinks that his father is a left-wing social democrat who misses Minnesota 30 years ago when he could have been over here. Meanwhile, he's content to be here. Now, Robert Kennedy started off working for Senator McCarthy and was here. Then he became interested in civil rights, working for his brother, and he moved over here. Then he's over here most of the time until occasionally he'll make a speech and he moves over here. So, for the next year, Robert Kennedy has no real position. He's kind of in a holding pattern up here. So that's really his position. Now, you can use the chart a lot of other ways. We don't have time tonight, but for instance, you could use it to classify people romantically. Not men, because men approach women like a sports program, but girls. In other words, a girl who'd kiss anybody on the first date would be a left-winger romantically, and a girl who insisted on kissing them on the second date and building toward a marriage in the suburbs would be a right-wing social democrat. If she tried to rehabilitate guys and then kiss them on the third date, she'd be a left-wing social democrat. If she wouldn't let anybody kiss her on any date, she'd be a right-winger. Automatically. You know, she might go out with a guy for a while, then he'd get bored, and another guy would move in. She'd say, goodbye, Tom, but I can't compromise and kiss you goodnight. It's a 13th date. Later on, guys would try to kiss her because she still looks good and mislead you that way. And she'd say, no, please don't touch me. I just came out of a great relationship, and no one can share what I had with Tom, including Tom, if you want.
Coat heel mark shield. It shields against Tommy's black heel marks.
All of them?
Just about.
Terrific.
Now, I'll wax hard enough to form a heel mark shield. Hard gloss glow coat. So hard, it takes a pounding and keeps on shining.
Hey, wait!
I gotta get a shield for my floor.
It shields against black heel marks. Hard gloss glow coat.
Deep in a bug-infested jungle, a new backyard insect fogger was tested. Its name, Raid Yard Guard. Kills flying insects 20 feet away. Clears them out in minutes. Keeps bugs away for hours. Raid Yard Guard lets you enjoy outdoor living. Clears flying insects out in minutes. Keeps bugs away for hours. Raid Yard Guard, the jungle-tested bug killer.
Recently, I came across something that touches all of our lives today so profoundly and yet so poignantly that I'd like to share it with you. It was written by Howard Vincent O'Brien, and it's called simply, So Long, Son. There was no band, no flags, no ceremonial. It wasn't even dramatic. A car honked outside, and he said, well, I guess that's for me. He picked up his little bag and his mother said, you haven't forgotten your gloves. He kissed his mother and held out his hand to me. Well, so long, he said. I took his hand, but all I could say was, good luck. The door slammed, and that was that. Another boy had gone off to war. I had advised waiting for the draft, waiting at least until he was required to register. I had pointed out that he was not yet of age. He had smiled at that and assured me that his mind was made up. He wanted peace, he said. Without peace, what good was living? There was finality in the way he said this. Finality at once grim and gentle. And I said no more about waiting. After the door closed behind him, I went to my room. On the wall was a picture of a little boy. His toothless grin framed in tawny curls. The same little boy who had just taken my hand and said, well, so long. Not much time, I thought, between the making of that picture and the slamming of the front door. Not much more than a decade. Suddenly, a queer thing happened. Objects came alive, whispered to me. The house was full of soft voices. They led me up to the attic, to a box of toy soldiers, a broken music rack, a football helmet. a homemade guitar, school books, class pictures, a stamp album, a penny bank with the lid pried off. Ancient history, long hidden under dust. The voices led me on to a filing case and a folder stuffed with pages and report cards. Letters. Among them, the wail of an exasperated teacher. Though he looks like an angel. A ribbon, won in a track meet. Faded photographs, one taken on the memorable first day of long pants. And a bit of golden hair. I sat down and thought how time had flown. Why, it was only yesterday when I held him on my arms. That somehow made me remember all the scoldings I'd given him, the preachments, the exhortations to virtue and wisdom I did not myself possess. I thought, too, of that last inarticulate good luck, that last perfunctory handclasp, and I wished that I had somehow been able to tell him how much I really loved him. Had he perhaps penetrated my brusque reserve? Had he perhaps guessed what was in my heart? And then I thought, what fools we are with our children, always plotting what we shall make of them, always planning for a future that never comes, always intent on what they may be, never accepting what they are. Well, curly head, you're a man now, bearing your bright new shield and spear. I hated to see you go out of my house and close the door behind you, but I think I would not have halted you if I could have. I salute you, sir. I cannot pretend that I am not sad, but I am proud, too. So long, son.
Here it is, the big question. What gives Tarentan the taste worth fighting for?
Tarentan tip! It makes Tarentan tobacco taste even better.
That's right!
Tarentan's got a charcoal tip and a white one, too. Together, they improve Tarentan's fine tobacco taste.
Congratulations! You sure know your cigarettes.
Well, all I know is, us Tarentan smokers would rather fight than switch.
Tarentan.
I'd like to say thanks for being such a wonderful audience and making my evening so enjoyable. At this time, 2 weeks from tonight, ABC ushers in the summer season with an exciting hour of entertainment from London, the Piccadilly Palace. It stars the great English comedy team of Morecambe and Wise and the talented musical star, Millicent Martin. So for an exciting hour of British and American stars, take in the Piccadilly Palace starting 2 weeks from tonight. And next week, the one and only Bing Crosby concludes the current Hollywood Palace season just the way he started it, with another great show. So, good night, my friend.
The American Tobacco Company, makers of Tarentan, the charcoal tip cigarette with a taste worth fighting for. And by Bristol Myers, makers of Bufferin. With Bufferin, you've got more going for you against headache pain. More than with simple aspirin tablets. Bufferin. This is Dick Tufeld speaking. Don't forget, next week in the Hollywood Palace, Don Ameche, the King family. Francis Langford, Barbara McNair, Louis Nye, Pollock Brothers Elephants, Yonelli, and your host, Bing Crosby.
What kind of a world are we facing? A world of competition, where having wise leadership makes all the difference between success and failure. This is where the colleges count for America. They supply most of our leaders. College is America's best friend. Give to the college of your choice and keep our leaders coming.